theorem. So what is superposition theorem? Actually there are two sources here. So the current is flowing, we have to find out the current flowing in this branch, okay, in this branch 220 ohms. So when the two sources are present, some current will flow, okay. Then superposition theorem means, so when one source is shorted, this is a voltage source, we need to short one source and we need to consider only one source, okay. What is the current flowing here? It is I1, and when you short circuit this source and when you, you present this source, the current flowing in this branch is I2, okay. So now I1 plus I2 should be is equal to I, okay. This is superposition theorem, okay. Now let us connect the circuit. First we will measure the voltages. So we need 30 volts for one source and 15 volts for one source. Here we have another source is there. So if you observe here, plus 15 and minus 15 are written. Okay, so if you consider between these two points, these two terminals, you will get 30 volts. Let us measure it first. How much it is coming? Let us measure it. So here we are measuring the voltage. So it is a 200 volts voltmeter. So actually it is showing 31.7 volts. Okay, so you also take 31.7 volts here. 31.7 volts here. Otherwise your theoretical and practical values will be vary very much. Okay, so now we have already set this to 15 volts. Okay, so this is used as second source and this is used as first source. Now we will connect the circuit from 30 volts positive end to the 1 kilo ohm. Here 1 kilo ohm we have already set here, and from 1 kilo ohm the second terminal, another 1 kilo ohm, and another 1 kilo ohm second terminal, you give to 15 volts first terminal, 15 volts positive terminal, from 15 volts second terminal to 220 ohm second terminal, and 220 ohm second terminal to the supply 30 volt supply second terminal, and this 220 ohms first terminal to, we need to connect one ammeter here in this branch, ammeter negative, even positive also no problem, but the value will be negative, that's it. So from this terminal to 1 kilo ohm, the first 1 kilo ohm second terminal, okay, you understand the connections. Next, switch on the power. Now let us see, the current flowing in this is 32.1 amperes. So the current flowing here, it is 32.2 amperes, okay, sorry, it is milliamperes. So here this is 32.2 milliamperes, this I, okay. Now let us connect the second circuit. So let us connect this circuit. So here we need to keep 30 volt supply, but we have to short 15 volt supply. So here this is 15 volt supply, so let us short this one. So we will connect these two terminals shorted, okay. So now let us switch on again. So the current is 21.8 milliamperes. So I1 here, it is 21.8 milliamperes, okay. Now let us switch off, and we will place it as it is. And now we will short the 30 volt supply. Okay, now let us measure. So the current is 10.3 milliamperes. So this is I2 is equal to 10.3 milliamperes. Now if you add 21.8 plus 10.3, you should get how much? 32.2 milli, exactly it is matching. Okay.
32.1.
Okay, 32.1 milliamperes. So this is the max superposition theorem. So first of all, you need to verify it theoretically, then see the values practically.